tell you guys a little bit about myself. I'm done with college, you guys. Holy shit, right? It took me 8 years. Just want to be clear with you guys that when I say that it took me 8 years, I'm not saying that like I'm going to be a doctor. I also want to be clear that when I say that I'm done with college, that is not the same as me saying that I graduated college. I didn't do that. I was a film major before I dropped out, which makes that much more pathetic. It's not really noble when you're just like struggling through biochem work. Mine was more like, what'd you think of Avatar? I don't know, I have anxiety! But I love movies so much, I watch them all the time. I think I watch them a little bit too much, though. I feel like I have this warped perception of reality. I'll tell you about this. I saw La La Land recently. Good movie, check it out if you haven't seen it. But as I was leaving the theater, the first thought that I had was, oh man, I really relate to that Ryan Gosling character. But like, do I though? Do I relate in any capacity to Ryan Gosling? When Ryan Gosling looks sad, he looks like a puppy that somehow still manages to be sexy. When I look sad, I also look like a puppy, but like an ASPCA puppy, where you're like, oh my god, change the channel. No. Ryan Gosling looks like Ryan Gosling, and I look like Bill Nye, the science guy's bisexual niece. And you won't laugh, and then I'll feel good about it. Today is not that day. I do love movies that go all the time. It's a detriment when you go all the time, because you see a lot of shit movies. Worst movie I saw last year was Batman v Superman Dawn of Justice. Did anybody see that? I got some staunch no's from this table. You made the right decision. There's a scene in the movie, and I'm aware that no one cares. There's a scene in the movie where Batman's about to kill Superman. You guys know Batman, the murderer. He's about to kill Superman. And Superman's final plea before he's killed to Batman is, you're letting him kill Martha. You have to save Martha. Because like 10 minutes earlier, Lex Luthor kidnapped Superman's mom, whose name is Martha. That was the whole reason they were fighting in the first place. But you guys, do you know who else's mom's name is Martha? Batman's mom's name is Martha. So Batman throws down the spear that he's grafted out of kryptonite. It's a dumb movie. And he's like, oh my god. And that doesn't make sense for a couple reasons. First off, who calls their mom by their first name, especially in an emergency? If my mom was in trouble and I was driving to save her and I got in a car accident and the police show up, I'm not just gonna be like, you gotta save Christine! You're letting them kill Christine! I know what they wouldn't say to that. My mom's name Christine too. My farthest friends. Before the scene ends, Batman, he puts his hand on Superman's shoulder and he looks him in the eyes. He says, Martha won't die tonight. Which is nice. Turns out Murder Batman was a nice guy the whole time. But in the original script, that was not the line. The line in the original script was, no Marthas will die tonight. You cannot promise that, Batman. Martha is an old woman's name. Saying you're gonna be mid-fight with Doomsday and just be like, I gotta peace out, there's this Martha in Seattle on dialysis. Batman away! I was right when I said no one cared. I have one major complaint about it. The Beast is too hot as the Beast. Let me explain this to you guys. This is supposed to be a story about a woman who overcomes this hideous monster and truly falls in love with what is really inside it. And like 15 minutes in, I'm just like, I would. You don't have to change for me. Be my guest. There's a scene where he's hurt and she's like cleaning his wounds and he has like a fur six pack. I'm just like, what are we doing? What's happening? This is a kid's movie, goddammit. I watched the original Beauty and the Beast before the movie came out. I watched it. I used to watch it all the time as a kid, but I haven't seen it in a while. And I want to give you guys an update. That movie is really fucked up. I'll give you the lowdown if you don't remember. An old enchantress is making her way through the woods, and she happens upon a castle. She needs a place to stay. She offers up an enchanted rose as payment, and the 11-year-old boy prince who lives there turns her away. And for his arrogance, she transforms him into a beast and enchants the entire castle. And if he's not able to find love by his 21st birthday, then they are all doomed to stay that way forever. And that is tremendously unfair. Because I don't know if you guys remember being 11, but an old woman came up to your home and was just like, can I stay here? I'll give you a magic flower. You would say, no! And then she would say, okay, well now you're a monster until someone wants to fuck you. What? No one else is suffering. Nah, your best friend's a candle till he dies. What? Alright, at least only humans are suffering. Nah, the dog is an ottoman! Why are you doing this? Something that also that all the like the VR guest sequence, all the plates and the forks and the knives and all that shit are dancing, are all of those people? Like when she's eating with a fork, is she just sucking on some dude's face? This is a kid's movie. Help me out. Tell you guys this. A couple weeks ago, my girlfriend came up to me. She said, all right, Tim. Fuck, marry, kill. And I was like, yeah, that's the plan.